my name's Nina Dean. I'm head of Level 3 support here at Anaplan. I'm based in the York office and I've been here for just over 4 years now. I started as an analyst and team lead and now I have this role.
Hi, I'm Richard. I work in the York office also. I'm the team lead for the Level 3 team here in York. I've been with Anaplan for 3 years now. I started as an analyst as well and recently promoted to the team lead about 6 months ago.
So what are some of your key responsibilities here at Anaplan?
The analysts are the ones with all of the knowledge. They're the ones who know everything. They know what's going on. I need to coordinate that. I mean, just need to funnel their knowledge, make sure that they're concentrating in the right areas. When we've got big issues going on, like I said, the analysts will be deep into kind of like what they're actually trying to focus on, what they're trying to figure out, the root cause analysis. I just need to make sure they're kind of like focusing in the right areas, make sure we're doing the other things as well, like updating customers, updating the field, make sure that it's shown up to the execs as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I kind of see us as we're the customer's kind of guardian angel, and we're constantly there looking out for them. We're looking after the prod environment for them. We're there, we represent the customer to engineering. So we're always there with engineering, making sure we're guiding them in the best possible direction for the customer.
And making sure we get the bugs fixed as well.
Yes.
So once the bugs are raised up from the customer, we need to talk to the product team and the development teams to make sure that they are actually looking into these, make sure they're not just concentrating on new features, make sure that bugs are actually getting fixed. What are some of your most enjoyable aspects of your role?
The team, love the Level 3 team. We believe we have the best team in the company. We get to work with all parts of the organisation. We get to work with the customer success teams, the product teams, the engineering teams, and best of all, we get to work with customers. So we get that view from all angles and we get to know everything about everything, yeah. Which we love.
I honestly enjoy coming to work. I look forward to seeing the team for the day, but I enjoy kind of like looking at the challenges that we've got ahead, seeing how we're going to tackle them, organising it, and just working with everybody, working as a group, as a team, and tackling those problems head on. And once we do kind of like find a resolution for the customer, once we go back to the customer with what we've found and the customer's happy, that is such a great sense of achievement, such like good. When you've had that teamwork together, it does feel like you've really achieved something. And obviously you've made the customer happy, which is what we're here to do, yeah.
So what is something that customers don't know about you or our team that they should?
Probably lots. Probably loads that they don't know about our team. I think one of the things that might surprise them is supportability. I don't know how wide that is at other companies who do kind of like this role, but when the development teams are developing a new feature, then we need to be there early doors to say, right, this is what we're going to need to be able to support it. And so we have to work very closely with them, making sure that we get things like the login so that we can identify the issues, making sure that however we're going to investigate the different issues, that we've got that tool in place to be able to do that.
Yep, so we're always thinking on behalf of the customer right from day one when a feature is started. So we're trying to be there to be that face of the customer and say, okay, this is going to impact us in this way, or we're going to need this to be able to make sure that our customers are properly supported once it's released. Sometimes that means that the engineering teams have to build us extra tools or deliver on, like Rich said, extra logging. That's something that maybe people don't know about us, is that we don't just get involved with the features after they're released, we're well before release as well. Mm-hmm. What does connected planning mean to you?
Connected planning. So for me, I think it's just a term that we use to remind people of what we are there to do, our capabilities, what we can actually do. So when you're planning, you obviously want all of the information. There's no point planning if you haven't got all of the data. And Anaplan can do that. Rather than having a bit of data over here, a bit of data over here, you can have Anaplan as central and you can have all of the data in there and you can kind of like just see your forecast. You can see how you need to plan ahead. Headcount, that's what we use it for.
Yes, it is.
But you've got to take all of that data in and there's no point having it separated out and trying to remember and seeing what you've missed. You need to have all of that data. That's what it means to me.
And to me, I guess it's as companies are kind of implementing this and evolving with the whole connected planning thing. What they're building is more complex, which means that as a support team, we're probably going to have to evolve in the way that we support them. So we need to be thinking about that now, and we may need to change the way that we have that in our processes. That's something for us to think about, and that's what's on my mind at the moment.
Thank you for watching.
And be sure to check us out on the Known Issues and Workarounds page on Community.